The most popular royal rivals, Princess Diana Spencer and Queen Consort Camilla Parker, have a lot of lavish mansions in their pockets to emerge as the winner in this battle of luxury grandeurs. Have you ever wondered what royal households look like? I bet you all will instantly feel penniless once you get to know the million-dollar estates these royal ladies owned. Let's end the debate once and for all as we compare the properties owned by Princess Diana and Duchess Camilla side to side. Diana's birth home, Park House. No doubt after marrying into the royal household, Princess Diana experienced some spectacular homes to live in. But wouldn't it be wrong to portray it as some kind of rags-to-riches story? Rather, Lady Diana lived life like a queen, even before becoming one. I mean, for instance, take a look at her birth house itself. Lady Diana Spencer, born in July 1961, was one of the fortunate ones to be born as a daughter to the royal family that lived in the Sandringham Estate, England. Their monstrous property was known as the Park House that looked as if it jumped straight out of a Disney movie. This Sandringham estate belonged to the lady's mother, who was waiting in line to be the next queen. Did you know that this dreamy real estate property was built back in 1863? Spread it across an area of 25,000 acres, the Sandringham Palace of England surely knew how to make heads turn. It was built by King Edward VII, who had acquired the region of Sandringham just a year earlier. At that time, an estate that included a giant swimming pool, an equally enormous tennis court, and a humongous garden was not a small deal. The Victorian palace had over 10 bedrooms, 12 bathrooms, and a central hall with a gigantic chandelier at the top. If you want to look at a house dreams are made of, then the Sandringham Park House is here for it. Oh, did I mention that in 2020, the Park House Palace was turned into a hotel for disabled people running off charity? The Duchess of Cornwall's birthplace. Is it too bad for Camilla Parker Bowles to not actually be a royal but live life like one during her childhood? Camilla, who is currently the Queen Consort of the United Kingdom, lived an uncompromisable posh life as she grew up in Lanes. This 5.27-acre ancestral house situated in the British countryside has that historic touch to it. For a matter of fact, the same mansion is estimated to be $3.87 million in today's market. Way to go, Queen! This English manor has a poolside dip, those authentic English lawns, separate hideouts throughout the gardens, and lastly, a paddock at its disposal. It has 7 bedrooms, 9 huge bathrooms, and the perfect mix of Georgian style blended with English architecture. Well, we are pretty sure that the one who constructed it wanted the house to scream countryside. The countryside kitchen has a way towards the central living room with wooden furniture from its tip to toe. Oh, did I forget to mention the royal master bedroom, which offers spectacular interiors? I bet the one who built this mansion wanted to be a part of the royal clan so bad. I'm not even kidding, would you look at the antique rug and stone tiles all around? The welcome reception, happy hideouts at the garden, and the casual dining room are definitely not the ones to be missed out. Man, don't you sometimes wish to just sit and adore classic British architecture all day long? Althorp House of Diana and her London flat. Well, it was time for the Spencer family to bid goodbye to the Park House. By the time Diana turned 14, her family moved into this infamous Althorp House. Spread it across an area of 13,000 acres. The property belonged to the Spencers for over 500 years. When I say it's huge, I mean it. The palace has over 90 rooms and a 115-foot-long picture gallery alone. The Georgian grand entrance has wooden panels, and Diana's favorite wooden hall offers one of the finest architecture England has seen yet. Did you know that the wooden hall was Diana's favorite place to dance her heart out? Although Diana and Charles met for the first time in this palace itself, tables were turned a bit differently. Charles was dating Diana's sister at that time, who unexpectedly passed away and was buried at the same place. Hence, the then 18-year-old Diana fell in love with Charles at first glance. If I was in the place of Charles, I wouldn't have thought even twice to go for it, to be honest. By the time she turned 18, the future princess called it quits living with her parents. It was then when she moved to her own studio apartment in London, paying €18 monthly as rent. The royal princess shared her room with 3 other maids. If you thought depositing $50,000 for an apartment is too much, wait till you hear the same single flat sells for $3.15 million in today's date. After her death, Princess Diana's dead body has been buried in the same Althorp mansion, just like ancestors. I bet walking into the royal family was the biggest mistake she did. Don't you think the same? Historic home with her ex-husband. This commanding historic 80-acre mansion created a buzz in the market recently when it was put to sale. If you have that kind of money, then you can buy this property for a whopping amount of $4.7 million only. Wait, if you think it's too much, wait till you see everything the property has to offer. Starting from the huge front lawn and a mini garden of its own, it's pretty evident that Camilla's ex-husband was surely interested in collecting plants of various species. The ex-couple moved into this ancestral house built in the 16th century in the year 1973. Situated on the top of a hill, the mansion has 8 huge bedrooms, attached bathrooms, and a fully stoned aesthetic. In short, the house is worth the money it's enlisted for. The front lawn has a separate region for organic farming too. The property includes numerous outhouses, with Prince Charles and Lady Diana having two of the most frequent visitors then. The current Queen's ex-abode has been under sale currently, having a lineup of interested buyers running for it. Sometimes I feel I should start a GoFundMe campaign of my own just to buy this property, you know? Clarence House. Finally, the moment we all have been waiting for, the same house shared by Charles Diana and Charles Camilla. The Clarence House is one of the last pieces of historical architecture in the entire United Kingdom. I know Clarence House is more popular for being the permanent residence of Prince Charles and the Duchess of Cornwall, but not a lot of people know that Diana and Charles lived here too. Right after their engagement, the 19-year-old princess moved in with the then Prince of Wales to the Clarence House itself. Once they got married, the couple moved into their personal Kensington Palace. On the other hand, after Prince Charles and Camilla Bowles got married in 2003, they moved into the same mansion right away. Camilla and Charles have been staying here for over 20 years. Now that the Queen has passed away, we are yet to see if the royal couple, with their newly imposed royal duties, will move into Buckingham Palace or not. I think they might have to stay back, as the palace has to be renovated for the future generations that might take 10 years to complete. It sucks to be the royal sometimes, doesn't it? On one hand, Princess Diana had a golden spoon since her birth, but forgot to shine upon her later. On the other hand, Camilla Parker leaped her way into the throne of Queen aptly, don't you think? We would love to know your favorite mansion from the list in the comment section below. My personal favorite is the Althorp House of Spencer's. As we leave, I would love to have a huge thumbs up from your side and wait for you in another interesting upload from our channel.